feel if your partner was best friends with their ex? On last night's episode of I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, Shane Warne opened up about his former girlfriend Liz Hurley's relationship with her ex, Hugh Grant. Have a look.
It's hard on your new relationship when you're really good friends with the exes. Like some, Elizabeth was really good friends with Hugh, who's like a best friend. Hugh Grant, a best friend. So when I used to go back to Australia, if she wasn't leaving London, he'd come and spend the weekend at the house, and I'm like,
What's that?
No, we're just friends and all. And I went, well,
friends doesn't mean you
need to
stay over.
So when I'm there, tell him to come there when I'm there. Yeah. I mean, I knew Hugh before I knew you, so just tell him to come over. And then he said, oh, no, he feels uncomfortable. And I was like,
okay, well, then it's not just friends.
Well, what's going on? He's uncomfortable. Okay, let's make sure he's okay.
So, can you or should you stay friends with your ex? That is today's Daily Dilemma. James Weir from news.com.au joins us. Hey. So, James, I have to say, this is not only a hot topic on this show, it is a hot topic in my household.
Why? You've got a few mates that are exes?
I have lots of friends who are exes, and my lovely partner, hello, darling, absolutely hates it.
Why does he hate it?
Because he thinks that they're up to something.
Okay.
Are they though? Can't you be friends with exes?
I think you can.
No, because then you have to give their stuff back.
Okay. You want that Bananarama CD that you had in the 80s, man? Yeah, you want to keep it. Well, I think in Warne's case, he's showing a little bit of insecurity, and I don't think that comes as a surprise, but in the jungle, we are seeing a bit of a vulnerable side because him and Liz, they did date, or it's Elizabeth, as you called her. Did you know?
Everyone calls Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, if you don't mind. They dated for about 3 years, and, you know, they shared many things, probably toothbrushes, probably fake tans.
White jeans. They love the white jeans.
They do. They shared a lot of stuff, so a lot of history has gone down. And you can imagine how threatening that would have been when Hugh comes back into, you know, her life. They were dating for about 13 years over the 80s and 90s. And this person who not only has slept with Liz, but also knows her probably better than what Warne does, that can be so threatening as a partner.
And I think he's not married, is he?
No, he's not.
So that's a bit
and
of
he's got
a...
About
I think if he was married,
kids.
It wouldn't be such a threat.
And also, I think, to the fact that he's not comfortable, Hugh Grant's not comfortable going down to stay there if Warne's there.
Yeah.
To me, that says everything.
That does. So,
I just want to know what he's doing to Warne's toothbrush.
Great. No, I wouldn't even want to touch Warne's toothbrush. So, but, you know, did you notice that Warne did say Hugh would only come when Hugh was out of the country, when Shane was out of the country? So, you know, that does...
But I reckon that is the whole thing. And I reckon, like, I'm pretty good friends with a few of my exes and stuff.
You're very good friends. You borrow their car. They come and stay with you.
Hang on. Joe's a user.
That's right, yeah. Yes, I borrowed a car, but yes, I also left her an unpaid parking ticket. So, you know, it balances
out.
What
do you think about this? Is she okay with it?
She was okay with the parking ticket. But I think that's a sort of different case because she's actually married to my best friend, so there's nothing...
Yeah.
That actually makes it weirder. But I would hang out with my exes quite happily and have a drink or whatever, but... To be honest, it would not be the same if my wife was there. And that's because you just wouldn't be able to talk as freely, you wouldn't be as relaxed.
But
and I reckon that is a sign.
For a reason.
That's right, and that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
That's why I reckon you can't be too good.
Can we also remind ourselves about why Hugh Grant did become an ex? Remember his certain little friend
I can't imagine staying friends with somebody who had done to me what Hugh Grant did to Liz Hurley. Or rather, what Hugh Grant did to Divine Brown.
Right. Yeah. But also, I mean, when those two were dating, they were at the height of their careers and both of them probably were at the height of their problems as well. So when someone's known you and supported you through all that stuff, I mean, yeah, you do end things for a reason, but it can be so comfortable to have that person on your side.
Well,
I'm actually in the process of building a friendship with an ex.
No.
Well, my therapist thinks it's a rubbish idea.
I love the fact you're going to a therapist about it.
Just to get through this. She says it's like trying to have your cake and eat it too. You know, because...
But it is fun.
It is.
Well,
yeah. Well, she says that, you know, it's like, you know, you break up for a reason, you choose to walk away, and when you try to be friends, it's just like picking the little parts out of someone that you like and going, I don't want to deal with the rubbish, and that's probably not really stable ground.
But if you just call off the romantic entanglement and just keep the friendship, that's where my partner is.
There's always, when you split up with someone, someone wants to split up more than the other.
Exactly.
So there's someone who still holds
a bit of
the flame.
The person out of love says, oh, that's great, we'll be friends, we'll just hang out. And the person who's in love goes, oh, yes, we'll be friends and maybe we'll get back together.
Yes, and maybe I can convince you again.
Understandably, we've been hearing loads from our dear viewers at home on this. Let's take a look at what you've been saying. Kelly says, my best friend is my ex. I'm happily married and they are good friends too. It is definitely possible.
Wow. Okay.
Debbie says, nope, I was told you can only be friends if both are happy in a new relationship. Personally, I couldn't be friends with an ex. They are an ex for a reason.
That's what you say.
And finally, Shani says, staying friends with an ex is a bizarre thing. It's only important to do so when there are kids involved. As far as I'm concerned, you break up for a reason, so stop it all there. Oh, my goodness. I love this topic. It could go on and on. So for more on the ex debate, head to news.com.au and please thank James Weir.
Yeah, James!